We're a group of council members who believe that there's a role for government in people's lives. And we want to stand up for the average person in New York City. And we believe that their voices were not being heard. And we want to be the voice for those people who we believe had not had their voices heard. We stand for better government. We stand for making sure that our schools are adequately funded. We stand for making sure we have adequate social services. We stand for the immigrants, 68% of which my community is made up of 68% immigrants. Mm-hmm. These are the people who we believe are not being heard in city government. The mayor is using the economic situation to take away some of the benefits that have been hard fought for over the years.
The newly elected councilman for the Jackson Heights area is sharing his top priorities. On Monday, Councilman Daniel Drom spoke out about acceptance and diversity. Elected in November, Drom represents one of the city's most diverse neighborhoods and is also openly gay. Drom is also the newly elected chair of the City Council's Immigration Committee. He says his top priority is helping immigrants locally and citywide.
My top priorities are really to ensure that our immigrant population has access to quality education, to health care, and to fair and equal treatment as every New Yorker would expect in the city of New York.
Drom previously was a public school teacher and civil rights activist for 20 years.
Today, to have this type of organizing effort in Left Rack City is making a huge point. It's telling the city, it's telling the mayor that we are not going to accept less for our communities. We are here today to demand from the mayor that he put back into the budget the money that's necessary to keep our library open.
Well, it's historic, and we have a very large Asian population in Elmhurst, one that is oftentimes overlooked.
Ladies and gentlemen, if we're going to talk about real reform in the New York City public school system, what we must do is involve our parents and our teachers in that school reform. We don't need to close schools from the top down and say, that's it, you don't have a voice, tough luck, move on. We're not going to accept that. We are the people who are most invested. We are the stakeholders. Our parents are the stakeholders. Our children are the stakeholders. They're the ones who get one chance at having a public school education, one chance in life to make sure that they get the quality education that they need and they deserve.
These children are slipping through the cracks, so to speak, and they're not getting the services that they rightfully deserve. And that's why this piece of legislation is so very, very important.
And Daniel Drom, is the newly elected councilman from this district here, and he works down at City Hall. So he's elected to take care of local New York City issues. But Danny is not only very proficient in English language, he's also expert at Spanish. Well, he speaks Spanish.
Concejal Daniel Drom se pregunta entonces por qué el alcalde eliminó fondos para estos programas en la ciudad de Nueva York.
Ningún centavo para este programa. Y nosotros en el Consejo Municipal de la ciudad de Nueva York estamos tratando de poner el 5 millones de dólares en nuestra parte de presupuesto.
This year we thought, wouldn't it be wonderful if we could expand it even further and close it down for the months of July and August. After we had the ribbon cutting ceremony and people in the community found out about it, it was tremendously successful. And it has really become another center of the community in Jackson Heights.
A donation opens the door for immigrants in the city who would like to learn English. Queens Councilmember Daniel Drom today presented a $100,000 check to a local group from the Immigrant Opportunities Initiative. The money is part of $4.5 million citywide that will be used to help fund English classes for immigrants. Drom says he hopes more funding and outreach capabilities will become available in the future.
It was a long and a hard fight, and the fight will remain because we've got to make sure that going forward, our immigrant communities are protected from the cuts that the mayor has been proposing.
But this district does represent the hopes and aspirations of our recent immigrant population and people who have come to this country to basically live the American dream.
When we have a bad economy like this, I think people look to scapegoat others.
Why is this prime spot vacant? One councilman's take?
Well, this is the shining example of MTA incompetence.
The $130 million rehab of the 74th Street Roosevelt Avenue hub created 14 retail spaces. That was 2005. Three spots are still unrented. Almost a year ago, with service cuts looming, elected officials complained. Now, with the fare hike coming next month, frustration's only grown.
They promised me that this store right here behind me would be open by September as a pizza parlor. And as you can see, they've had a lot of success.
Councilman Daniel Drum and members of Community Board 3 made the announcement Wednesday.
You hear people in the community who say, you should do this or you should do that, or what can we do about this or what can we do about that? Now is the opportunity for people to get involved.
So having these types of green markets contributes to the mission of what this hospital is about as well. Because this hospital is about producing healthy people, healthy lives, helping people make the right choices in their life. And having a market like this available to the community reinforces what the hospital is doing here.
We realized that if any firehouse was not able to respond in the way in which they did, we could have had a tremendous potential for loss of life in this community. They don't close a firehouse here in Jackson Heights, and they close one in Flushing, or they close one in Long Island City. We are still going to be affected here in Jackson Heights because they are going to pull firefighters from Jackson Heights to go fight those fires in Flushing, or they're going to pull them to go fight the fires in Long Island City.
Miembros del Consejo Municipal que ven el asunto como uno de suma urgencia.
Yo creo que nosotros estamos gastando dinero en camas que nosotros no estamos utilizando en Upstate New York. Y yo creo que hay una manera mejor para tratar estos niños que tengan problemas. Y cuando nosotros tengan los niños aquí en la ciudad, más cerca a las vecindarios donde ellos viven, es un mejor tipo de tratamiento.
A woman in Corona died because ambulances couldn't get to her house. It took an hour and 45 minutes for EMS people to respond because they couldn't get down the street to her house. Well, look, the mayor's job is to get rid of the snow. All anybody has to do is look out their window and they'll see that the snow is still there. That being said, in the past, this job was done. I don't know what went wrong this time. We're going to hold hearings in the city council to find out what went wrong, but something definitely went wrong. But I think that it set the tone for what's going on, and I think really the pictures that should have been out there was the mayor doing something. My office, for example, we put out a picture. I had to get an ambulance out of a snowdrift.
Right.
Okay, and so I went out and I started pushing ambulances out of snowdrifts. I went to people's homes and I knocked on their doors. I made sure that their streets were cleared so they could get dialysis. I went to the nursing home in my neighborhood to make sure that there was access for ambulances to reach those people. And all the right. Mayor puts out a picture of him drinking soup.
Realidad, no hay nada que alguien puede hacer para hacer su advocación más rápido con los Estados Unidos. La única cosa que puede hacer su advocación más rápido es comprehensive immigration reform, es la reforma migratoria. Esta es la razón que las organizaciones como se hace el Camino Nueva York.
Jackson Heights has the least amount of park space of any district in the whole city.
Parkland and park space, especially in this district, are precious. People really want to see this deal happen.